Hi, and welcome to this video about manipulating equations. In this video, we will be discussing these three main concepts, seeing what each is, why we need to know it, and how we use it. Carrying out the same operation on both sides of the equation, the advantage of combining like terms, and canceling terms on opposite sides of an equation. Let's get started. Before we jump into it, let's quickly review some background information to ensure we're on the same page. Remember that an equation is a statement of equality. The equation 2x plus 4 equals 10 tells us that the expression 2x plus 4 is equivalent to the expression 10. It also tells us that there's some value of x that will make the expression 2x plus 4 actually equal 10, and therefore make the statement true, which in this case, x would be 3. 2 times 3 plus 4 equals 10. All other values of x make the statement false. For instance, if we tried to say that x equals 5, the left side of the equation would equal 14, and therefore not be equal to 10. Okay, now let's get into the first concept, carrying out the same operation on both sides of the equation. Since the two expressions on either side of the equal sign are in fact equal, we can use any operation we want on one expression as long as we do the exact same thing to the other expression. This is generally known as keeping equations balanced. It produces equivalent expressions and does not change the value of x that makes the original statement true. For example, we can subtract 7 from both sides, which would give us 2x minus 3 equals 3. The statement is still true when x equals 3. 2 times 3 minus 3 does in fact equal 3. Or we can divide all the terms on both sides by 2. So we have our original again, 2x plus 4 equals 10. And if we divide each part by 2, that gives us x plus 2 equals 5. Again, when x equals 3, the statement is true and all other values make it false. 3 plus 2 equals 5. Typically, when given an equation, we want to isolate x using addition, subtraction, multiplication, or division so we can see its value. So, even though we can manipulate an equation using any terms we want, there are certain operations in every equation that will help us reach a solution. Now that we've got that down, let's discuss our next concept, combining like terms. Combining like terms is an important equation-solving step that is usually done before any actual solving begins as a way to simplify the equation. To combine like terms, add or subtract all of the terms with the same variable. For example, consider this equation. The 2 and the 3 in the second set of parentheses are like terms, so we can combine them. Doing so gives us this, 2 times x plus 3 plus 3 times x plus 5 equals negative 4. Now we can carry out the multiplications that are implied by the parentheses, distributing the outer 2 and 3 accordingly. 2 times x is 2x, plus 2 times 3 is 6, plus 3 times x is 3x, plus 3 times 5 is 15, equals negative 4. The 2x and 3x terms are like terms, so we can add them together to get 5x plus 6 plus 15, equals negative 4. Now, the constants 6, 15, and negative 4 are also like terms, and we can combine them as well. Subtracting 6 and 15 from both sides of the equation will give us this. 5x equals negative 25, which simplifies further by dividing by 5 on both sides to x equals negative 5. Let's look at another example. In the equation, 2x plus 4 equals 16 minus x. We need to get the x terms on one side and the numbers on the other. We can add x and subtract 4. This will give us 3x equals 12. Or we can subtract 2x and subtract 16. So if we try this one again, we have 2x plus 4 equals 16 minus x. And if we subtract 2x from both sides and subtract 16, that will leave us with negative 12 equals negative 3x. Regardless of the steps to combine the like terms, the solution is the same, x equals 4. Divide by 3 on both sides, and we get that x equals 4. And here, divide by negative 3 on both sides, again gives us that x equals 4, since dividing a negative by a negative results in a positive. Now on to the third and final concept we're going to cover, canceling terms on opposite sides of an equation. Sometimes, manipulating terms in an equation is called canceling, or canceling out. Two terms on opposite sides of an equation can be canceled if and only if they exactly match each other. They must have the same variable raised to the same power and the same coefficient. Canceling can be done by using any of the four operations, but there is a more specific way to think about what we're doing. When we add or subtract a term to both sides of an equation, we're making a zero by adding the opposite of a term. In the equation, x plus 6 equals 13, we would solve by subtracting 6 from both sides. By subtracting 6 from both sides, we made a 0 on the left side, since 6 minus 6 equals 0, allowing us to solve the equation. By the same token, in the equation x minus 5 equals negative 4x, we might subtract x from both sides to make a 0 and find the solution. Then we'll divide by negative 5 on both sides to get that x equals 1. With multiplication and division, the goal is to make a 1. In the equation 3x equals 9, we need to make that 3x into a single x by dividing both sides by 3. Since 3 over 3 equals 1, we were able to solve the equation. Thinking about manipulation in terms of making zeros and making ones will help you determine the path to finding a solution to any equation. Let's practice a couple before we go. Solve. X minus 3 over 2 equals 6. Make a 1 by multiplying both sides by 2. X minus 3 equals 12. Then make a 0 by adding 3 to both sides. X equals 15. Solve. 8x plus 7 equals negative 11 minus x. Make a 0 by subtracting 7 from both sides. 8x equals negative 18 minus x. Make another 0 by adding x to both sides. 9x equals negative 18. Make a 1 by dividing both sides by 9. X equals negative 2. I hope that this video increased your equation manipulation skills. Thanks for watching and happy studying.